In-person collab, so I think
excited.
This is actually my first in-person collab.
Really?
Yeah. So I'm really excited, and we are doing a back-to-school collab, so that's pretty fun. I'm doing some weird DIYs for school that you should try, and she's doing...
I'm doing types of people at school.
So totally check that out, and comment on her video that you came from this video. So if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe down below, and if you want to go enter my huge back-to-school giveaway, I will link it down below. It's my last video, and I'm giving away like a backpack, all the school supplies, so go enter it. But without further ado, if you guys want to watch weird school supplies that you should try, then just keep on watching. I'm not a little kid. So obsessed with this first DIY. It's these DIY emoji coasters, and I think these would be perfect for anyone's room. All you need are round cork pieces, acrylic paint, and then some different size paintbrushes. So all I did was started painting the cork pieces with the yellow to represent the emoji. And then I took a little bit of a smaller brush and started drawing the eyes, and I had a picture next to me so I knew how to kind of do it, but I did the little kissy face, which probably is my favorite one just because it's so cute. But yeah, this is my favorite one. I made four of them, so four different faced emojis, and it was so simple, so easy. And the awesome thing about these are they don't have to be perfect whatsoever. These are just little decorations for your room, just to kind of like spice it up. I don't know, I think they're so cute. I'm definitely gonna be using them for my room. You guys should definitely make them and tweet me pictures, and we can be little coaster twins. Hashtag gold. Watch me get big now. My second DIY is this DIY strawberry kind of fruit pencil case. These are so easy to make. All you need is a red pencil case, some felt, some glue, and a black Sharpie. So all I did was measure out the felt to match my pencil case, and then drew the little leaves to represent the leaves on a strawberry, and then I just cut that out, glued that on, and then I took the little Sharpie and kind of drew the little seeds to represent the seeds on a strawberry. But I think it's so adorable, and you guys should definitely try it out, and yeah, let me know how goes. And you can definitely make like other fruits. I have a bunch of different options. I will leave the other ones down below, but it's kind of like the same concept and really easy, really adorable, and you should try it. All the time, yeah. Need it in my life, yeah. Guess what we're making? Oh yes, we are making some edible chalk. So these are so easy to make. All you need are three things: candy melts, straws, and some powdered sugar. So I melted all the candy melts and put it into a bag. And then what you're gonna wanna do is take the melted chocolate and put it into the straw, and then put that into the freezer for about an hour. And then it should be hardened and it should slide right out, kind of looking like chalk, little chalk pieces. And then you pour that into the powdered sugar, or pour the powdered sugar onto the chalk kind of pieces. And that's it. It totally looks like chalk. You can totally eat it, and it kind of tastes good. So yeah. My next one is a DIY backpack that I love. It's like a watercolor kind of tie-dye print. All you need is like a white or tan color canvas backpack, and then some fabric paint that you can like use on your backpack and it won't wash off. So I just started off with wetting my whole backpack so it's easy to watercolor and kind of blend all the colors, and then I added all the colors with a little cotton round just so it's really easy to blend. I did that to the whole backpack with about four different colors. If you want it to look a little bit more watercolor looking, I recommend adding a little bit more water in between like every color, and it should become like a tie-dye watercolor backpack. I think this turned out so cute, and I loved all the colors together. Very fun and bright, and I love it so much. So yeah, that's how you make this very easy DIY backpack. Add a lot of water, mix everything, and it should end up looking very cute and girly and fun, and yeah. So I hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you did, don't forget to thumbs up. Go check out Clarissa's video. I will link it down below. And subscribe to her channel. Also, don't forget to go enter my back to school giveaway. If you're watching this right now, don't forget to tweet and Instagram us pictures using the hashtag Kalexa. So we will like all of them that we see, and that would be super awesome. Yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I love you so much, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye! Bye.